Hey guys, it's Tamara from SparkleBunnyCottontails.com, and today I'm going to be making some thing out of clay with this Crayola air dry clay. So as you can see, I have a glass of water and a knife because I don't want to ruin any of our real silverware. And here's my clay right here. And then as you can see, I also have this box, Pringles box, and I'm going to just break this up so that I can have a clean workspace. Just so I can have my workspace all clean and covered so that this clay doesn't get on the desk. Now, I'm going to open this up. Okay, so I'm just going to roll up my sleeves. And I'm thinking of making a little dog out of the clay. So I'm just going to shake a chunk of clay out. Okay, so now I'm just gonna put this to the side. Okay, now here's my ball of clay. I'm just going to mix this around a little bit on my hands and get it a little warm so I can move it where I need it to be in a minute. So yeah, I'm just gonna mix this really quickly. A snake. Okay, so I'm almost done. Now I have this all mixed up now, but I have one last thing I need to do right before I get started shaping my little dog's body. I need to roll this into a good smooth circle. Okay, that's almost good. Here's my ball now. As you can see, it's very smooth. Now, I'm going to just kind of flatten this out just a little bit. But before I flatten it out the rest, I need to take off a little chunk, and I'm going to just set this back into the bowls so I have this for my body parts later on. So here's my clay. I'm just gonna recarve that back into the ball. Okay, so I'm just gonna flatten that out really quick. Now here's my ball, and now I'm going to start just pushing the sides together a little bit to make my dog skinnier, and then just slowly push a tiny bit of that together. Now I'm just going to smoothen that out and let that sit there for a second, just so that it will smoothen out a little bit more. There. Let's push that together a little bit. There. Now my little dog won't be so fat looking when I finished with it. So I'm gonna just take my knife here, get a little bit of water on it, and just kind of rub that on there. Oh no, the knife didn't have any water on it. So instead I'm going to dip my fingers in that and just kind of rub that clay together and get that line gone so that my dog's body is not all cracked when I dry it. Okay, so here's my clay, and as you can see, I smoothed out that crack in it. Now I'm just going to do that to the rest of the body and just smoothing out its edges and everything like that. So I'm almost finished. Okay, so there is my smoothened out clay body for my dog. Now I'm going to take my knife and just take a little bit and slice it up a little bit and so that I know where I can put my little legs in a second. So there's my first scratch spot, and I am going to take out the clay that I put in here before. There we go. And I'm going to just take a little piece off of that and roll that out a little bit like a snake leg. I mean, a snake for my little leg. Then, if you want, you can just shape that a little more like a pod. Oh no, I'm gonna re-roll that because I messed that up. Okay, I'm just gonna restart the piece of clay and roll it into a ball and straighten that out. There. And then that looks enough like a pod. Then remember how I scratched that up a little bit? I'm going to just scratch that up a little bit now too, so that they're both good. Then you're going to take some water and just rub that on there a little bit so it's, the water is sort of like a glue, and then just stick it on. Okay, so there's my first leg. I'm going to take that extra water that kind of came off of it and just rub that together. Okay, so I'm just going to take a tiny bit of clay out of my bowl and not use any more of this for now because I need that for later. And just take about this much out so that I can stick that around my leg and make sure that it will stick on good enough. Sort of like packing snow onto a snowman's head. Now I'm ready to do my next leg. Now I'm just going to take some of that off, roll it into a ball, flatten it out. No. Flattened it out to look like a pancake. There we go. I'm gonna make sure that that's about the same size as the other leg. Good. Now I just need to scratch that up a little bit. Then scratch a tiny bit of that up. Now I'm going to take my water again. Rub that a little bit. And when you rub the water onto your legs and body, just, it's good. good to remember that you don't want to cover up the lines too much so that it won't stick the most. Now I'm going to take a little bit of this on here and take it off and just kind of stick it around the edges so that this will stay on. Okay, so now that's my next leg. And here's my next piece of clay for my next leg. I'm gonna roll that up, flatten it out. You know what? I need a little more clay just so I can make it a little fatter, just like the other legs. I'm gonna roll that up now to make sure it sticks all together. Roll that into a snake shape. Scratch. Wait. Good. Scratch that up. And I know that when I'm scratching this up, it sort of looks like I'm ruining my clay, but it's just so that I can get my clay to stick together good enough. And it should go away once you let it dry. Here's my little piece of clay. Just pat that on. There, I used a little too much clay and I'm gonna stick that on. I just need a little bit of water to flatten that out. There, now I'm on my last little doggy leg. Little more. Okay, so I'm gonna roll this together now. A little more for that leg. There. There. There's my little doggy leg. That's too big. Let's make sure that just like this one. Yep. Let's scratch that up. And this. Now just take a little bit of water and stick it. Okay, now I'm just going to take a little bit of this again and make sure that that stays on. Okay, so there's my little doggy legs. Okay, now I'm just going to stick those on a little more just to make sure they stay on. And take a little water and just flatten out those areas where I stuck the legs on. There we go. Now, I'm going to start forming the head with this clay, but I need to take a little bit off of here. But really quick, I'm going to make the little tail for my doggy. And this tail is going to be curved. Ah, that almost broke. Curved out. Okay, so there, I'm going to scratch a little. have this upside down is just so because I don't want this to flatten out and just become a big body again. So, there. There's my little tail. Now for the last step, my head. I need to make sure that its head is perfectly rolled out with no cracks. I'm just going to take a little water and rip it all around here to make sure there's no more cracks anymore in here. And here's my little doggy head. Now I'm just going to stick it right there. You know what? I'm not going to do the head that small. I need a little more clay. And there's the clay now. Then I'm just gonna flatten the bottom of that out a little bit so that my head gets a little more wide. Take a little water again, wrap it all around. Good. So now I forgot one step last time before I put the head on. I'm going to actually take this Expo marker and stick it. Well, I'm gonna see which one's taller. Yeah, the Expo marker is taller, and I'm going to just set my dog like that so that my feet and my legs on my dog don't flatten out too much. Okay, now I'm going to stick my head on after I scratch up the area. There we go. I just need to scratch a little bit of the head up now. There, take my water. Look at that and that. And there's my little doggy head. Okay. Now, I'm just going to make a little ear with my extra clay that I used for the packing the legs on. There's my little ear. I'm just going to flatten it out a little bit. Scratch a tiny one right there. Get a tiny one right there. Get it wet. So there's my first ear. I need a little more clay out of here now. Now, I'm gonna roll that out. Flatten it now. There's my two little ears. There. Now I'm going to add a little tiny nose. Here's my little, really tiny nose. Right on my thumb. Okay. Now I'm going to just add a little bit of water right there before I do my scratch this time. And gonna take a little more clay and make that a little bit of a snout, actually. Okay, it's a little bit of a duck beak, but that's better. Now I need to take a little bit of clay now, again, and roll it into my new nose. Flatten it out, and I'm not gonna do any dots. I'm just gonna add my little nose onto my dog. Now it looks more like a dog. Take a little bit of more clay. Roll it into a ball. And this is going to become my little tooth hanging out of my dog's mouth. And if you guys hear a little bird chirping noise, that's because of my brother. He is playing with his little pet that we got him for Christmas. Here's a little more clay. There. Now these teeth are so little I don't even have to do the scratches and water. Okay, so there's my teeth. Now I'm just going to make a quick little tongue before I do my eyes. Let's roll this up. Flatten it out. I'm gonna stick that like that. And with this, I will do some little scratches because I'm going to make two little lines for his tongue. There. And with this, I will do a little bit of water just so that stays on. This is going to go right by the teeth. And I know it looks a little weird right now, but tomorrow after it dries, I'm going to come back and paint it. Now I need to do my eyes, and my eyes are going to be a little bit bigger. There's my first eye. I'm gonna roll this out. And before I stop the video to let this dry, I'm going to actually put a little color on it with some more clay. And this time I need this much clay just for the color. I need to roll this up into a big snake shape and see if that will fit. That means I need to keep rolling just a little bit more. And then it should be good. Oh no! Looks like I might just need some more clay. I'm gonna set that down so I can get this open. There. I got some more clay. Now it's time to roll again. it from clay so I can do a little tag on its collar. I guess I need to do this on my hands. Pull it up, flatten it out. There's my little tag. And I'm going to just do some little lines to make it look like it has a name on the tag. There we go. And well, I'm going to pause the video just for the night and come back and show you guys my dog tomorrow and paint it then. So here's my dog so far. My little ears, my tongue, my nose, my teeth, my collar, my feet, and my legs. So, see you guys tomorrow.